also the mental ways, physical ways, to accept the foundation, the various problems in the parts of the body, like the stomach problems, the problems. And they try to find self-treatment, self-treatment or self-coping treatment, like, for example, drinking too much, smoking too much, taking drugs, to try to reduce the stress. And of course, they can be mental illnesses and self. Now, very simple, anxiety is the commonest condition that you find in stress, depression is the second, and actually psychosis is not very common. Substance abuse is very common, especially smoking and drinking, and personality disorder and psychological disorder. Anxiety is a psychophysiological response to a psychological stress. Hence the word, some people say, I've got this worryness, too much of worry. Hence the multiple physical symptoms, but no physical disease. I'm a big target, can't sleep. But actually there's no disease. And they keep on going to our house, which doctors getting tests done, x-ray done, PCR done, but nothing wrong, nothing physically wrong. Mentally, emotionally, socially, there are tests. You have to really find out what the tests are. Sustained anxiety can produce rejected, hated, as there is no end to the stress, no right end to the stress. If anxiety or worry continues and continues and continues without stress, eventually the person becomes very dejected, very depressed. That's when they have even thoughts of suicide, killing themselves, and so on and so forth. I come from a few students, they have come to the university, they started the music course, and then after 6 months, I want to go. The parents said nothing to me. So they become depressed and they take it over. If they go home, they'll be in trouble. If they stay on, they cannot concentrate on the studies because that's not the cause they want. So that can lead to the problem. Same thing, marriages are not a person who's forced to get married to a boy because she's going out to some other boy with the parents object. And then she finds she really doesn't want to be the best in the world. So she takes the advice and ends up the hospital. And we find that actually the problem started with before she got married, that the parents actually get forced to get married, which she didn't like. So that can be a major cause of this, and then she becomes depressed. These are pictures of depressive masks. You see how the person is depression is half the time and then a few weeks ago. This is the picture of a famous Hungarian poet by the name of Mandela. He had chronic depression and committed suicide. And he wrote objective poetry in his life. And having his program, the two humanities all broke up because of chronic depression. Suicide is a long-term outcome of this chronic stress of suicide. There's ample evidence of close relationship of stress to precipitating of physical diseases, for example, SARS CoV 2, insomnia, hypertension, coronary artery disease, decreased immunity, autoimmune diseases, stroke, epileptic seizures, migraine, and myelodysplasia, the nervous system, and people who are anxious and depressed and chronic stress. So basically, it's not from anxiety, from stress, which gives rise to anxiety, which gives rise to depression, and then to some of the cardiovascular diseases. Many heart diseases are precipitated by stress. I come from numerous diseases. Common signs of stress are insomnia or poor sleep. For no reason. There's not no reason. There is something. You just cannot sleep for it. I mean, when you sleep because you're keeping up awake, late to see the World Cup football, that's not a problem. For no reason, suddenly you can't find the problem. Decrease in interest, environment, increase in normal lifestyle, preoccupation in public, autonomic, related function, gastric, cardiac, pain, skin. These are indications that the person is probably under some kind of psychosocial or emotional stress. What causes coronary artery disease? Cerebral artery disease, high cholesterol, lifestyle diseases, eating too much alcohol, smoking, links of hazard, sexual degree, external stress. None of these people actually have stress. This is where some people are going to stop being off. Going for a massage and going for positive. This advertisement doesn't appear anymore. But the advertisement of massage for those people with sexual dysfunction. And this is often the result of stress. The mental health connection to physical illness is what the patient says. No health without mental health. A lot of the stresses really start in the mind because of psychological and social stress. It's a much neglected aspect of health. It doesn't measure quantitative values. I'm sure before you join in the future, you would undergo a medical exam. But nobody checked to find out if you're mentally healthy or not. So some of you may be mentally unhealthy, but you're still in the future. In fact, to reassure you, even if you join in the universities and academic staff, or join the government services, or doctor, nobody does a test for your mental health. They only test your physical health. So some people may not be mentally healthy to work a job. Mental health is closely related to physical health, not recognized. Early signs of mental illness manifest by behavior changes, more than physical changes. Gradual behavior change will improve the effects of self-cure, substance abuse, and serious alcohol abuse. Stress reduction attempts by substance abuse improves high pressure foods, sugars, salty foods, overeating. High risk taking behavior sports, outlet for stress, variation of stress, and how many jobbers are so high. At least 25% of all primary care attendants, people going to see it, have a psychological reason for attending the patient. Not 25% to 30%. With a physical complaint, you come with a complaint at any time, but actually it's not physical. So, some people say the best way to look at it is somebody comes with a headache, and you can't find it. Ask a question, who's sitting on the bed? And you complain chest pain, who's giving a heart ache? Somebody is affecting a heart. And stomach aches? What kind of stomach aches? That's one thing. So the World Federation of Mental Health actually has come up with a to basically ask the question, how mentally healthy are you? Begin. Three questions they ask in detail are, how do you feel about yourself? How do you feel about others? And how do you need to answer what you feel like? Most people can answer how you feel about yourself is it all right? How do you feel about others? And when you come to how you need to manage your life, a lot of people find it very difficult to cope with their life. With their family, their children, their finances, their job, their studies, and so on. So, you add the whole lot of your family. Not many people are all that mentally helpful. Physically, very well, but mentally. Very well, he invented jogging. He invented jogging as a everyday sport. Now he went through two divorces and finally died from doing jogging. And he had suffered from anxiety and depression. He found that then jogging actually made him concentrate on the jogging and less on the stress. And produce more endorphins in the body, which actually made him do a bit of the endorphins. Eventually he died from it. So now we come to this. How do we prevent stress? Prevention, how do you prevent stress? And prevention is always better than cure. Now, the basic principle is this. You must balance your life. In diet, in exercise, in work, in rest, in relationship. You cannot just eat things for others or speak early. You cannot eat too much of that for sure. You cannot do exercise and do not rest. You're losing work. You must be prepared for accidents, natural, and disaster. No matter how balanced your life is, there will always be disasters, always surprises, always situation that it was prevented. So it turned out to be self-serving. If the worst happens, I still have something to fall back. If you reach another way, say, if I lose my job, I'm finished. That means you're not prepared. And of course, if you lose job, for example, right now, because of the oil crisis, hundreds of oil workers have been laid off. Thousands of them have been worldwide. They said, you can't afford to, you know, hire these people because they get so little profit. They said, if the oil price drops below $40, it is not profitable to pump out oil. You might as well $30 and keep oil until the price comes up. Why should you pay them salaries every month? So these are some of the reserves that you have got to have maybe to survive. Principles of mentalizing balancing choices of future. This is what the Buddhist philosophy is all about. You take the middle path. Don't go into making profit, money, making profit, making money, making money, making money. Or turning to God all the time, but don't make profit. You have to do both. So basically, you have to balance it. Know your limits. Control expectations. Control limits. Too much of going under. And the challenges of the bosses in relationships and positions. No bosom friend remains bosom friend. No enemy remains enemy. That no, in politics, nobody is a permanent friend and nobody is a permanent enemy. So you can see that in his life. One time, he was very fond of Anwar Ibrahim. It was he who brought Anwar Ibrahim into the government, into the Congress party. And later on, now he was arch enemy. Kapha Baba wants his rival. Therefore, Kapha Baba became his best friend. So like that, things can change, and that is true even in our relationship. If you invest too much in somebody as a friend, you'll be surprised when the relationship breaks up. But you should be open to that kind of stress. So prepare for losses in relationships and positions. Not to cushion your fall. First, you agree that for instance, there is a need to understand patience and work with balance. Train yourself to be tolerant, learn to accept. Learn acceptable. Challenging teachers to transfer. Very carefully advance yourself. Invest more in self as hard work. This is roughly what I mean. You have to have some time for work, some time for yourself, some time for home, your family, your children, and some time outside home and outside work. Now, participate in something. Religious activities, voluntary job, helping the others, that kind of thing. In those days, the ship was like this. The ship was big, open, any kind of vessel. It just sank because the water was rushing. Nowadays, on my front, they write that this kind of ship, different compartments. Even one compartment, even two compartments will be damaged. The ship can still leak onto the next part and survive. No one won't sink completely. All preparedness, justice will happen. All preparedness are seen as the best people. The best answers are to build up the cities, prepare all the authorities, reduce the level of dependence too much on others. The principle of reducing stress is recognize and anticipate what all the stress you are trying to do. More prepared you are, the less experience stress. There is no such thing as lifetime disease, only drive stress. Sigmund Freud said that there are two things that people do with blood pressure. There is to be loved and blood pressure. Now, if you find that you still cannot solve your problem, you don't have to have a I see a train comes here. We've got several train hospitals here. In every campus, and we are also training peer counselors, and training students to help counsel each other. And they act as a mirror. You do the changing, but there are no meeting solutions. So see the counselor of the next. There are also numerous other ways of reducing the effects of stress. Not the stress itself, but the effects of stress. Relaxation exercises, yoga, and religious education. Every religion has got Now, what will not help very much, people say, take ginseng. Then ginseng came the bosses and you take ginseng. Bosses do the same nasty boss. Holiday, then a holiday change and nagging mother-in-law. No way. So it's a temporary thing, really, for a few days. You come back, mother-in-law getting worse. So this kind of fact solution, I see them very often. Take a holiday, go for a job, listen to good music. After listening to good music, you listen to the bad nagging of your wife. What can you do? You have to go from there. Then comes the last one, meditation. Let us look at that anxiety. There are many effects of stress. That's needless as well. There are large quantities of antidepressants, quite safe otherwise. You may need antidepressants and Prozac if you respond to the level of less needed as a cause of stress and war. Even the U.S. military uses Prozac for stress in the army. No quick cure. The way to discover it and work over for us is to find a way to overcome the problem of personality, problems, failures of work, drugs, administration. No resources are answered. Too many people, too many people, too many selfish people can ask us to work. Too many people cannot solve the problem. So we all survive with stress. All religions are the best stress practices. We practice sincerely and daily. Not before exams. I think most of us turn to God when we are exams. God, God, please help me pass my exam. I'll do anything for you. You know, somebody gave me a joke about it. He said, I'm sure it was. He was going to, a fisherman was going to sea. And storm started, terrible storm. And the boat overturned. Would lose all his fish. And he went down. Oh, God, please save me, save me. If you save me, I'll give you everything I have. So God heard him and said, stop the storm. He pulled his fellow back to shore and gave him back to shore. After he came back, he went to visit. He said, God, actually, I'm not that rich. I can't give you everything I have. If I give you everything, then I got nothing. God said, God, you're going to cheat me. I said, you can't go back to the storm. So, like that, when the exams come, don't promise, go to church regularly, go to temple regularly. Go and say, okay, mom, help me a lot. Exam is over, that's the last you heard of God. Until your wife kicks you out of the house, then you call it. That kind of religiousness is amazing. You must practice the principles of Christian, which is no good, no good. Don't be greedy, give more than you receive. Now that is the real principle of what's up. So, the last slide is, when I was talking to Catherine, I saw this mirror. Basically, it said, this man is responsible for your safety. And then there was a mirror. A no man, except me. And the realized what the mirror was about. The safety in this realization depends on you. Now, change it. This man is responsible for your stress. You are responsible for your own stress. Learn how to prevent stress and overcome stress. So, that is the last slide. And then, questions are you.